Am I the only one here so far?
I'm here. And you know that Pam will be late.
Calm down. After all, the stores are always open when you shop online. I wonder what has her so excited that she has to show it to us now.
Who knows? Whatever it is, I'm not going to let her try to convince me to change my style. The t-shirt factory has always taken care of me. Do you know they've started to sell sweatpants as well as t-shirts and shorts? That makes it the perfect shop for me.
Oh, that's terrific, Dorothy Ann. There's no doubt that you'll find a matching set of something there when you go there next.
Sure, I like your tone, Ellie. To me, comfort is the name of the game. Come on, Pam, we're waiting. Why did we ever agree to do this virtual show and tell?
Well, personally, if Pam has found some new fashions online, I'm happy to take a look. I'd like to add some color to my wardrobe and
Don't say anything. Just wait for it. What do you think?
I think I couldn't really see anything.
Pam, we can't see all of you when you move away from the screen.
Okay, let me do it over again. These are my new boots. This is my new skirt. This is my new top. And this is my new do. What do you know? What do you think?
I think I'm going to be sick.
Pam, what's happened to your hair?
Oh, I have added a hair accent. Bold color highlights make a statement.
I'd call that a scream for help.
A hair accent. I thought for a second that something had died in your hair. Is it permanent?
No, of course not. I just decided to update my look. I may be in my early 60s.
Early 60s?
But I'm not ready to abandon my sense of fashion like others I could name.
Listen, girlfriend, the only things I've abandoned as I age are the blood, sweat, and tears of trying to be someone I'm not. You, on the other hand, work way too hard to keep up with the kiddies. Why the sudden change from your usual sorority girl look to middle school maven?
Well, I saw Kitty Bryan when I was at Terrace Teeter last week. She looked so modern and chic. And in comparison, I felt dowdy and old. So I decided that maybe I should start to dress in a more youthful style. After all, she's not that much younger than me.
She'd be about 15 or 20 years younger than you, depending on your real age, and give or take 2 or 3 days.
Dorothy Ann, please mute yourself. And Kitty, oh, bless her heart, has always had the fashion sense of a...
Oh?
Unbelievable, Dorothy Ann. How your wardrobe hardly qualifies you to judge how Kitty dresses.
Of course Kitty is not a... I mean, I've never seen her take money from a man in public. Pam, what are you doing?
Just getting comfortable. Forget about Kitty. I decided I wanted a more youthful look. So I bought a few fashion statements, and then I went online and I searched until I found a trendy new site called Debs Debacle. I chatted online with one of the clerks there who helped me to pick out a complete ensemble. And I had shipped it overnight. I bought another few things that I wanted to show you. No, don't feel bad. My new look isn't meant to make either of you feel bad about dressing your ages. Most older women tend to be uncomfortable making bold fashion statements. But not me. I intend to have the eyes of all the men at Harris Teeter on me when I go shopping next week.
Their eyes are going to burn right out of their sockets after looking at you.
I don't appreciate your comments, Pam. I don't need to make juvenile fashion statements just because I'm older. I dress, as always, with classic style that retains my dignity, something that most people will assume you have tossed if you wear either of those get-ups.
How can you say that? I'm not trying to offend you. I'm just trying not to lose my true self, which is no more than 30, to old age.
No real 30-year-old would want to dress straight from the pages of Marie Claire. Can you spell?
Please stop.
Desperation.
I'm struggling in this decay, inside this decaying body.
Oh, thank you, Dorothy Ann, for getting us to this point in the conversation. Pam, look at me, please. What's this really about?
For a long while now, I started noticing things about myself.
What things?
Oh, things like sagging skin, wrinkles, veins, blotches, and even hair sticking out of my nose.
Come on, Pam, you can't just have begun to notice those changes. We've all been going through it for years. It happens to every woman once we turn 60, and sometimes even in our 50s. Hell, it started happening to me when I was 35. It is what it is.
It may happen to all of us, Dorothy Ann, and to some more than others, but it's not who I am, not who I want to be. Although, it probably doesn't matter anymore. Next month, I turn 67.
Since when is 67 considered to be mid-60s?
And I have to face the fact that at this point, I'm officially considered old. And I'm no longer appealing to men.
Dear Lord.
Why can't I mute you? Pam, aging doesn't have to prevent a woman from looking good. You know that. And your inner beauty is as radiant as ever. Besides, men have always been attracted to you. That hasn't changed.
Oh, they used to be, but I have lost my edge. Besides, the number of eligible men in my age group has decreased.
You mean deceased.
It's easy for you to say that aging doesn't matter, Allie, because you're in a relationship. But I'm not, and I haven't been since my divorce from Ron. When I first became single again, I still felt attractive and sexy. But now that I've moved into my 60s, I just feel old. I don't give a hoot about inner beauty. I want to feel physically beautiful. And I'm not aware of any woman my age or older who are still considered sexy or attractive.
Excuse me? Really? You don't notice any?
I mean, well, Ellie, you are very pretty. You know that. You're just amazing in a sturdy and placid way.
You make her sound like a cow.
For your information, my style of dress is a model of subtle sexiness that is timeless, as demonstrated by the famous women who follow classic fashion, such as Audrey Hepburn, Grace Kelly.
It would help if you could name someone who's not dead.
Jane Fonda. Diane Keaton, Goldie Hawn.
You don't understand. I don't want to be classic. I like to stand out, and I like flirting with men. I want to notice men. I want to date, and I want to...
Okay, we get the picture. We don't want the details.
I need to look better than classic to get men's attention. And after all, now that I'm a cougar, I guess I can dress with a certain flair.
Do you know what a cougar is, Pam?
Of course I do. It's an attractive older woman who is on the prowl for men.
I didn't think so.
A cougar is an older woman who is on the prowl for younger men.
Younger than herself? Really? Mm-hmm. How much younger?
It's not a formula. 5 years younger, maybe more.
I wouldn't care about dating someone a few years younger than me, but if they were younger than, say, 65.
You don't want to date a younger man, Pam?
Well, it's just that younger men are so, they are so overly intense and sweaty.
Oh, my God. Listen to me, Pam. You will soon be closing out your 60s.
No.
Oh, can it, Dorothy Ann? And while you still have a shape that could be the envy of many a younger woman, you're not even interested in attracting men who are younger than you. So, given the age group of your prey, you have to understand that as a woman of age who wears a certain age, who wears fashions designed for
children,
for much younger women, you are not going to be viewed kindly by old guys.
Why not? Men love looking at women who wear fashionable clothes.
Well, maybe. But in that outfit, you'd be setting expectations that most of the men in your age group probably don't have the energy to meet.
Listen, Pam, Ellie's being kind, but she's right. The guys you're going after don't want to be challenged to prove themselves as red hot lovers. Besides, the reality is that there's not a man in the world, even if he's old, who would prefer to look at an equally old woman.
Yeah, no matter how attractive she is.
When there's anything younger nearby, younger women compete for and win a man's attention no matter how they dress, just by having firm butts.
Yeah, boobs that don't sag.
And non-wrinkled skin. Booyah!
Well, that doesn't mean that you can't be fashionable. You can wear stylish and even sexy fashions while retaining your dignity. And by doing so, you'll prevent yourself from being perceived as a desperate granny who is trying way too hard to regain her...
It's not lost. It's just gone.
Well then, flatlined and never to be resuscitated youth.
I don't want to be seen as desperate, and I also don't want to look like someone's grandma. And I'm tired of spending most of my time trying to look younger than I am. Polishing and painting, tweezing, peeling, shaving, squeezing, sloughing, and no matter how hard I try, I swear I can look in the mirror every hour and see something that slipped, sprouted, or wrinkled. I'm exhausted.
Maybe it's time to start thinking about the value of aging with dignity, dressing with self-respect, and not embarrassing one's friends in public.
Despite my exhaustion, if maintaining the work means, among other things, that I'll end up dressing from the just give it up fashion shop that you frequent. I won't do it.
That's enough, ladies. Pam, we're not suggesting that you don't take care of yourself. We're only saying that as a woman of age, you need to cultivate more than your physical charms to flirt. Older women have plenty of flirt left in them. Just remember that the men in our age group, that
the ones that can move between the TV and the bathroom without help,
are having their own body image problems. And you don't want to make them feel less than perfect. Develop some new strategies.
Such as?
Well, such as playing games. No matter what their age is, most men like to play games, especially games that help them to demonstrate their knowledge and their capability. Games make them smile, and that's a good thing.
Never have seen you play games with Ed.
Oh, Ed and I play lots of romantic and flirting games, just not so much in public. Once or twice a week after dinner, I challenge him to a game of putting in our backyard. We each take a glass of wine to sip while we play. We laugh and talk in between putts. And I always, always ask Ed to help me hold my putter more effectively, which he does by standing behind me and holding me very close.
That sounds interesting. Mm-hmm. But I'm not good at sports.
Golf is a game, not a sport.
I'm almost afraid to ask, but what do you do, you and Harrison, to flirt with when you are together?
Harry and I cook together.
I know you like to eat.
Oh, seriously.
Okay. Tell me about cooking.
Yeah, well, we take turns dicing and slicing. Then we feed each other bits of food while we're cooking. Sometimes we have food fights.
Oh, you don't.
We've made a pact not to throw food that has been dipped in sauce. It's too hard to clean up. Although it can be fun to lick it off Harry's cheek.
Now that's romantic. Even though it's not really a game, it actually sounds kind of fun, and it could be very flirtatious. Mm-hmm. It would certainly make me smile as long as my clothes weren't ruined. Okay. You have both given me a lot to think about. Thank you for being such good friends. So, let's go to another website I found.
Oh, not yet.
What do you mean, not yet?
We're not going to look at clothes until we could look at you with a straight face.
Mm-hmm. You don't like that shirt either? It's really the latest.
No.
All right, I grab a sweater or something.
Before you go, turn slowly so we can get a good look at, oh my God.
Why are you dressed only in tights? I thought you were wearing a skirt.
Yeah, one that looked like a cloth umbrella, for heaven's sake.
I wanted to be comfortable, so I slipped it off. After all, it's just a Zoom meeting.
What if someone had knocked at your door, needed your signature or something?
Well, it's not like I'm naked.
And thank God for that, although I have to admit I like the boots.
Yeah, Dorothy Ann's right. The boots are sweet.
I believe the correct with it term is sick.
Well, I do have great legs, and I don't mind using my boots, showing them off.
And don't take all day. We haven't even begun to look at clothes.
Just give me a minute. Wait a minute.
It'll take her an hour just to find a sweater.
Oh, I need you to help me Decide which of these tops are best.
I thought you were just going to get a sweater.
Well, what if somebody does come to the door? Maybe the man from UPS? Or the Amazon guy would be even better. I need to look my best just in case.
Dorothy Ann, would you help her choose, please? I can't do this anymore, and she needs our help, or we're going to be here all day.
What she needs is a muzzle and a tranquilizer dart. Pam, I'm going to count to three while you pull something out of that pile, and whatever you pull out is what you'll wear. One, two, three. Oh, my God.
What's wrong now?
He pulled out a thong.
Of course I did. I always wear thongs. They keep my panty line from showing. Unlike the unboxer type undies you buy. I believe I'm going to put these on with my boots instead of the tights.
Why would you do that? No one cares about your panty lines.
Well, the Amazon guy might. I'll be right back, and then I'm going to show you a website that sells real clothes and not color-coordinated sweatsuits. The Amazon guy, the Amazon guy. No, I don't wear this shirt, but I will wear this instead.
I don't know.
Ellie, I really need to get some more chips before I see what she's thinking of wearing for the UPS man.
Oh, okay. Or the Amazon guy. Oh, Lord. Why do these things always... I never thought about wearing a thong. Maybe... I'll buy a few and see if Ed even notices.